guys, thanks for stopping back by Scraps to Mine. Want to share with you a few projects that I've been working on. May take a couple videos to show you, but in this video I'm going to show you what I did with my clear stamps and my wooden stamps. You're looking at my clear stamps, and I organize my stamps into the CD cases, just the clear CD cases like this. And as you can see, I have several, and I just put them in here. I label the sides of them with whatever the name of the stamp was and the company. Like this was Winter Christmas and it's Inkadinkadoo. And I also have a number on the side of them. This happens to be number 77. The reason why I'm showing this to you is because I'm going to show you what I've done to make the process of finding the stamp that I want very fast. I also have my wooden stamps located very close by in my cabinet right here. And they're in the third drawer here, and they're also numbered. Most of my big wooden stamps I leave on the block because I don't want to damage them, and so I just assign them a number. And I'm going to show you what I do to find the exact stamp that I'm looking for. So I'm going to take you over to my scrap table, and I'm going to show you my binder. Okay guys, I'm back at my scrap table and watched a video that Amy put out, and I just was like, oh my gosh, I need to do that. I cannot always find the exact stamp I'm looking for. Even though I have my stamps pretty organized, it did take me a little longer to find exactly what I was looking for, or maybe I had forgotten that I had a particular stamp. So thank you Amy and thank you Jen for this great idea. It was definitely time consuming, but I recommend it if you own a lot of stamps, if you want to use your stamps, and you want to know what you have and keep like a catalog of what you have. So this is my stamp catalog, and it's just a binder. I didn't decorate it, I didn't make it all fancy, I just want it to be useful. So I went ahead and printed out some titles for pages, and this one happens to be my backgrounds, borders, sentiments, and alphas, and this is the way that I arranged my stamps. That's the way that I look for them. That's what works for me. You'll probably organize yours a different way. Since all my stamps are located in the same area of my room, pretty much all of them are located in a stamp case besides my wooden stamps, my larger ones, this was really simple and painless for me. I didn't have to worry about, you know, organizing different areas of my room in the binder. I just put them all in here. I signed all my stamps a number like I had showed you on my CD case. Like this is number 5. So basically how I do this was, if I'm looking for a background, I come in, I go to backgrounds, and I just page through. Oh, I want this doily right here, this corner doily. Oh, I see it's number 123, and it has a W there, which means it's on a wooden block. So I just go to my little drawer that you saw. Those are all the wooden block stamps, basically, I own. Most of mine are in a CD case. And I know to just go to that drawer and look for 123. And I have it wrote right there on the side of my stamp, and there I go. It's that easy. Let's say I'm looking for a sentiment, and I want something that says like memories. So I'm going to keep paging through since I'm still in the sentiments. Oh, right here we go. I want family memories. Well, this is number 5. So I'm just going to go over to my CD cases, pull out number 5, and here I go. I have my stamp. So simple, so easy. I'm able to use more of my stamps. I just have them all in here. I have flowers and butterflies and birds and owls together, and it's just made life a lot easier for using my stamps. And believe it or not, I didn't realize how many stamps I actually had because I'm not using all these stamps. But now I definitely, it's so much easier. I need to make a birthday card. Boom, I go to the birthday section, I find exactly what I want, I go and pull it off of my shelf over there, and I can make it within like 5 minutes, and I'm out the door to the birthday party. I mean, it's so simple, guys. So thank you, Jen with Sprinkles, and thank you, Amyvlovestv. I really appreciate you sharing this with me and everybody out there, and I hope this inspires somebody out there to do the same thing. Oh, I want to also show you this one tip. Since I organize them by number, I leave a little sticky note here. You see 127, and that tells me that's where if I buy new stamps, I need to start numbering from 127. No matter if it's a wood stamp or a clear stamp, it doesn't matter. It's just I assign a number to them. It goes wherever in the category. And then I just, you know, put the new number here in case I buy another package of stamps and I know exactly which number to start with again. So that is my binder of stamps. Or I should say I'm going to call it my catalog. And I want to share with you guys really quickly. I know we all love a good bargain. I know we love the Target dollar spot. But I want to give you a little warning. I don't know if this just happened to me or if this has happened to anybody else. But as I was organizing my stamp binder, I came across a Target stamp that I had bought maybe 2 years ago. Maybe 2.5 years ago. And you guys, it's horrible. The stamp is basically disintegrating. I don't know if you'll be able to see this, but it's disintegrating. It's really, the backing is still on the CD case and it's sticky and it's just falling apart and it's gross. I mean, look at this. Look at that. It's left, can you see that? It's left some of the stamp there and I just think it's terrible. I mean, it's so sticky and gross. So just a warning, I know they're cute, but I'm not going to waste my dollar on Target stamps anymore. I'm going to end up buying a stamp from Michael's versus a dollar stamp from Target. So that's just a little warning to everybody out there. And I also want to share with you how I store my small dollar stamps that are the Studio G or let's see what else, Inka Dinka Doo stamps, and they are not in my stamp catalog binder. I do have a few in there from years ago when I started putting them into CD cases, but I have stopped doing that since they're so small. I don't want a CD case for every single little tiny stamp that's a Studio G. So what I do is I don't own very many. Like, some people collect the entire collection that comes out for seasons or whatever, and I don't do that. I just buy a few at a time that I really like. I try not to overbuy on stuff. I really just want to buy the things that I know that I'll reuse a lot of. So this is what I did. I have a 3-inch binder here, binder ring, and I left them all in the packages and I just slipped them on the binder ring, and then I hang this up and it's that easy. And I can just easily, you know, finger through this. If I'm looking for a butterfly stamp, here it is, you know, and I can just take it right off the ring, or I can just slip it out of the package and put it back in the package. They're in no particular order. You know, they're on here, and it's really easy. You know, this is really easy to take with you too if you need to take it with you. So that's how I store my small little stamps. So just another organizational tip. Thanks for stopping by, guys. I'll see you in a bit. Bye.